Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Ah, hari ini hari keempat di Kanada dan hari ini hari Jumat. Saya akan Jumatan di sebuah masjid. Nama masjidnya Masjid Islamic Islamic Society Information apa? Islamic Masjid Islamic
Islamic Information Society
of Islamic Information Society of Calgary. Nah, nama masjidnya. Kalau di sini dia ada dua katanya. Karena masjidnya seperti toko gitu, di rumah kecil. Ada dua kali. Sholatnya dua kali. Ini dikelilingi oleh semacam dealer. Oh. Ini Islamic Information Society of Calgary. Jadi ini bukan masjid, ini semacam toko ya. Assalamualaikum.
And so we forget Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, out of His mercy, He puts you in a difficult situation. Why? So you can turn to Him. Ibn Taymiyyah, he has a very beautiful quote regarding this. He says that when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tests a person and He puts them through a difficulty, but the person starts asking Allah and he humbles himself and he makes Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he shows his weakness to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And of course, this is a ibadah. And inshallah, he is rewarded for that. And so the person, he is doing that and asking for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to get him out of that situation. To give him that thing that he wants. But little does he realize that while he is doing that, his iman is increasing. And that ibadah and harwa and that submission to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will be something that helps him more and becomes more beloved to him than that thing that he's asking for, subhanAllah. And so this becomes actually a mercy from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala takes something for you, it's actually an act of rahmah. It is from His mercy that He's taking something so that He can turn back to Him. Because you have gone away from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, so He takes something back from you so that you can come back to Him, subhanAllah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will cause the earth to be dry and will stop the rain. So that the people will turn back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because they know that nobody has power except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And so it is mentioned that Musa alayhi salam and his people, one time there was a drought, and so they went down to pray. So this is not the prayer, to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to pray. And so Musa saw an ant raising its hand and asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for him. And he realized that act of salati, that act of going to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will answer the dua. And so he said to his people, "Irjou wa tawfiqou," go back, you have been sufficed. And subhanAllah, on the way back, they could hear the thunder and the clouds. And so when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does that, so people return to Him. So that people return to Him. From the name of Samad, we also learn that when we need something, we should go to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And even if you think about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, many of us, when we are in a bad situation, when we need a job, we go to our boss, we make our resumes, we send them to everybody, and then we ask Allah in the end for many words, subhanAllah. And it's